Good morning students, we have moved to chapter 4, that is chemical kinetics. What is chemical kinetics, or define chemical kinetics? Chemical kinetics is a branch of physical science which deals with the study of rate of chemical reaction and the mechanism by which a chemical reaction occurs. So it's a physical science branch. It's a branch of physical science. And what is it dealing with? It is dealing with the study of rate of chemical reaction, or rate at which a chemical reaction occurs. Like whether the reaction is occurring at a slow rate or moderate rate or in a high speed rate. And the mechanism by which a chemical reaction occurs. In what mechanism a reaction is happening. So these are the two aspects which the chemical kinetics is going to deal with. What are the two aspects? Rate at which the chemical reaction occurs, mechanism at which the chemical reaction occurs. Now consider this slide. You are able to see the three pictures. The first reaction is nothing but an explosion of atom bomb or hydrogen bomb. Explosion of atom bomb. This is nothing but a chemical reaction which is happening in a laboratory. And this is nothing but a rust formation, which is otherwise called as corrosion. Okay. See, this reaction happens very rapidly, and the reaction which is happening in the laboratory, that is addition of one reactant followed by the addition of the second reactant. So a color change observation. This is the reaction which is happening at a moderate speed, a reaction which is happening at a moderate speed. And this reaction happens at very slow rate. It takes months to years to develop this kind of corrosion. So reaction at a rapid rate, reaction at a moderate rate, and reaction at a slow rate. Now moving to the rate of chemical reaction. So rate of chemical reaction is defined as change in concentration of any one of the reactant, any of the reactant or the product at per unit time. So what is rate of reaction, children? I have my reactant. The reactant should react to give me product. So there should be any change in the concentration of reactant or the product at particular unit of time. That is, per unit time is called as rate of chemical reaction. Children, I have given one reaction where A is giving rise to B. A is a reactant and B is nothing but product. Yes. See, I have given in the down, the rate of chemical reaction is represented as minus delta A by dt is equal to plus delta B by dt. I have represented A with minus sign and B with plus sign. Why is this? Because you know the concentration of reactant is decreasing, or the reactant is consumed to give you the product P, whose concentration is increasing. So it is represented by plus sign, and this is reactant is represented by minus sign. Okay. Now what is this delta A concentration? Decrease in the concentration of the reactant as the time consumes. And what is delta B? Increase in the concentration of the product with respect to time. And what is that delta T? Delta T is nothing but your time interval. Clear? So what is rate of a reaction? When a reaction proceeds as the time consumes, the concentration of reactant is decreasing, which is represented by minus delta A. And the concentration of reactant is increasing, which is represented as plus delta B. And this all happens in a particular time interval, that is represented as delta T. Okay. Now, what is instantaneous rate and average rate of a reaction? What is an instantaneous rate of a reaction and the average rate of a reaction? See, instantaneous rate is defined as rate of change of concentration of any of the reactant or product at a particular time. See, the difference between rate of a reaction and instantaneous rate of a reaction is, there I represented per unit time, here you have to indicate particular point of time. That's all. This is the only difference between your rate of a reaction and the instantaneous rate. What is instantaneous rate of a reaction? Change in the concentration of either the reactant or the product at particular point of time or particular unit time. Say for example, I have the same reaction where A is giving rise to B. I have written the concentration of A as small a and concentration of B as small b. Now what is instantaneous rate? Instantaneous rate is equal to minus 1 by A. How many reactant of A? Only one. So minus 1 by A dA by dt is equal to plus 1 by B dB by dp. What I have added, children, here? Here I have added the concentration factor minus 1 by A, and here it is plus 1 by B. These are the concentration of reactant A and the concentration of the reactant B. Okay. Now, what is average rate? So you understood what is instantaneous rate and rate of reaction. Only difference is indicate instantaneous rate with a particular time period and that as per unit time. And what is average rate of a reaction? Average rate of a reaction is defined as rate of change in concentration of any one of the reactant or product at a particular time interval. They have given a particular time interval, say for a time period of about half an hour or 1 hour, like that. A particular time interval is given. In that time interval, what is the rate of change in the concentration of reactant and product is called as average rate of a reaction. Okay, clear? What is rate of a reaction and what is instantaneous rate of a reaction and what is average rate of a reaction? In average rate, we need to observe the change in the concentration of reactant and product within a time interval. Okay, let me explain average rate. For the same reaction, the average rate is indicated as minus 1 by A. Instead of dA, I have indicated as delta A by delta T is equal to 1 by B delta B by delta T. Okay, so this is the difference between three factors. Now, what is the unit of rate of reaction? The unit of rate of reaction can be represented as, since it is concentration and time, I can represent as concentration per unit time, or concentration unit is mole or liters and times unit is seconds. So it can be represented as mole per liter per second, or it is concentration per time. Okay, so till now we have seen what is the definition for chemical kinetics, what are rapid reaction, moderate reaction and slow reaction, and what is rate of a reaction, what is instantaneous rate and what is average rate, and what is the unit of a chemical, what is the unit of a rate of a reaction. Okay, next, this is a slide which indicates you here. See, there is a plot between your time interval and see C4H9, carbon is 4, methane, ethane, propane, butane. Butyl chloride, when reacts with water, give rise to butanol and hydrochloric acid. There is a plot on butyl chloride and a time interval. We have got a slope. This is instantaneous rate. What is instantaneous rate? Change in the rate of, or change in the concentration of the reactant or product at a particular point, right? So this is instantaneous rate at the time interval 0. Otherwise, I can tell you initial rate. And what is this rate? This is instantaneous rate at a time period 600. See, they have indicated this is, what is this indicates the time? This is 600 time interval. So at 600 time interval, what is the rate of a chemical reaction? So these two are instantaneous rate at a different time period. This is at initial time and this is at a time of 600 seconds. So this time interval I can tell you as the, I have given a particular time period and I have calculated the rate of the concentration of reactant and product. So I can call that as average rate of a reaction. Now, since we know very well about the rate of a reaction, we should know what are the factors which affect the rate of a reaction. See, we have 5 factors which affect the rate of a reaction. We will be seeing one by one. The first one will be concentration of reactant, temperature, nature of the reactant and product, exposure to light or otherwise radiation, and presence of a catalyst. What all these factors will do to the rate of my reaction, whether they are going to increase the rate of reaction or whether they are going to decrease the rate of reaction, that we'll be seeing one by one. Yeah. Next, the first factor is concentration of reactant and product. Okay. So what is the effect of concentration on the reaction rate? What happens to the concentration of reactant? When the concentration of reactant increases or decreases, what happens to my rate of reaction? That we are going to see. See, rate of a reaction always increases when the concentration of any one of the reactant increases. This is a fact. Suppose I have the reactant A, I have reactant B. They react to each other and I'll be getting the product as C and D. So obviously, if I want more product, I should increase the concentration of the reactant. So if I increase the concentration of any one of the reactant as A or B, obviously the rate of the chemical reaction increases. That's what is the first point. And according to the law of mass action, which we have studied in class 11, what is law of mass action? It is nothing but rate of chemical reaction proportional to the concentration of reactant or product. Yes, the rate of my chemical reaction should be directly proportional to the concentration of reactant or product. Yes, now we are going to see the rate equation. I have told you an outline of law of mass action, where rate of a chemical reaction is directly proportional to concentration of reactant and product. Now consider the reaction A plus B. These are reactants giving rise to P. Small a and small b are the concentration of the reactant. Okay. Now the rate of reaction as per law of mass action, it is proportional to the concentration of the reactant. So I have written concentration A, I have written concentration B, I have written the moles like small a and small b as prefix. I have written on the top. This we have already seen clearly in previous year also we have studied. So rate is directly proportional. So as we know the general rule, when I'm going to remove the proportionality factor, I'll be introducing an equal to plus I'll be introducing a constant. I have removed this directly proportional to, so I have put an equal to sign and I have written a constant. What is this constant called? You all knew this constant is called as rate constant. What is this constant called? This is rate constant or specific reaction rate. This we might not have seen. We have literally told K is equal to rate constant. What is rate constant's other term? By which term it is called? That is specific reaction rate. Okay, it is otherwise called as specific reaction rate. Now I am going to give you a condition where the concentration of reactant A is equal to 1, concentration of reactant B is equal to 1, and the rate of a reaction is equal to K. Now how will you rearrange the reaction? So in this case, your rate constant or specific reaction rate is the rate of a reaction when the concentration of reactants is unity. Now this reaction is called as rate equation. When the concentration of reactant A is equal to 1, the concentration of reactant B is equal to 1, and the rate of a reaction is equal to K, then that reaction is called as rate reaction. And what is that rate constant defined as? It is nothing but rate of a reaction when the concentration of reactants is unity. Okay, very clear about rate equation. Moving to order of reaction. Okay, next step we are moving to order of reaction. How we are going to classify the reaction as first order, second order and third order reaction. See, in the rate equation, the exponents of concentration term may not be equal to the stoichiometric coefficient of the balanced equation. In the previous slide, I have given the exponent of concentration reactant A and B as small a and small b. Now, this exponents may not be equal to the stoichiometric coefficient. When I balance a particular set of equation, the exponent which I discussed in the initial stages as small a and small b may not be equal to the actual stoichiometric constant in a balanced chemical reaction. See, for example, the reactant A and B giving rise to product B. I have indicated small a and small b for indicating the concentration of reactant A and concentration of reactant B. And how will I indicate the rate of a reaction? Where rate of a reaction is equal to K into concentration A and B. But can you see I have represented the concentration A as X and the concentration of B as Y. So what I mean to tell is, see, the initial stages I have indicated a small a and small b, and here I have indicated the concentration, the stoichiometric coefficient X and Y. So the exponents may not be equal to the stoichiometric coefficient in a balanced chemical reaction. So what I mean to say is small a and small b may not be equal to small x and small y. They may or may not be equal to A and B. So now what is the definition for order of reaction? Order of reaction is nothing but sum of powers of concentration terms which are raised in the rate law expression. So can you see this reaction? From this reaction, I'm going to define the order of reaction. So order of reaction is defined as sum of exponents. Here what are the exponents? X and Y. sum of exponents which are raised above your concentration terms. What are the concentration terms here? Concentration A, concentration B. So the exponents which are raised above the concentration terms are called as order of a reaction. So in this reaction, what is the order? X plus Y. What did I tell you? Sum of exponents which are raised to the concentration terms is called as order of reaction. So as per the definition, in this reaction the order is equal to x plus y. Okay, clear? Now see, but you know, these the initial exponents which I have expressed, that is small a and small b, that is from theoretical thing. But you know, your order of reaction is an experimentally determined quantity. I need to conduct the reaction, then I will be knowing the order of a reaction. So this is an experimentally determined quantity. So order of a reaction is an experimentally determined quantity. Say for example, the value can be zero, or it can be whole number, or it can be fractional number, or it can be negative. So order of reaction can be zero, whole number, fraction number, or it can take a negative value too. Now in the order of reaction is 1, then I am going to call that as first order reaction. If the order of reaction is 2, then I will be calling that as second order reaction. Now let me tell you an example for first order and second order reaction. Now consider the reaction where nitrogen pentoxide is giving rise to nitrogen dioxide plus half oxygen. Here I am writing the rate of reaction as, I have need to indicate the constant, right? So constant K into concentration N2O5. Now consider the second reaction where ammonium nitrate decomposes to give you nitrogen and two molecules of water. Okay. Now here I have written the rate as, rate is equal to, I have introduced the constant K and I have simply written the reactant. This is first order reaction. Why? Because when I calculate the sum of exponents which are raised to the concentration term, then it is almost equal. So here I am going to indicate them as first order reaction. Now consider the case of second order reaction where NO2 decomposes to give you nitric oxide and oxygen, hydrogen and iodine combine to form hydrogen iodide. See here the rate is second order, 2 number of NO2, so it is 2. Here the two reactants are included. So this is an example for second order reaction and this is an example for first order reaction. Now this is an example for third order reaction. See, where nitric oxide NO plus oxygen, it is nothing but reversal of that. NO plus O2 gives 2NO2. And NO2, that is nitrogen dioxide, reacts with chlorine to give you nitrous chloride plus oxygen. So this is third order reaction. I have written the rate of reaction, rate constant along with the reactants. I have written the rate constant along with the concentration of the reactant. Now this is a reaction where your order is equal to 3/2. That is a methanaldehyde decomposes to give you methane plus carbon monoxide, where I have written the rate of the reaction. And last, since I told you the rate of a reaction can also be zero, we have seen first order reaction, second order reaction, third order reaction, where they have taken the whole numbers. And I have told you an example for fractional number. And this is an example for order of reaction when it is becoming a zero. Say for example, decomposition of ammonia. We know this reaction where 2NH3 gives N2 plus 3H2. Here the rate of reaction is equal to zero. Here the rate of reaction is equal to 0. Now what is the unit of rate constant? We know what is rate constant K, and what is the unit of rate constant we are going to see now. See, for a zero order reaction, we know this is a reaction rate. Okay, rate of a reaction is equal to rate constant into concentration A, and what is the power? The power is 0. So here what is the unit? Since concentration mole per liter and time period seconds, done. For first order reaction, what is the reaction rate? Reaction rate is equal to K into concentration A, power 1, I didn't indicate. And what is the unit? Should be concentration per mole, or it can be seconds. And for a second order reaction, what is the reaction rate? It is rate constant into concentration to the power 2. This is second order reaction. Here what is the unit? It should be mole per liter per seconds 1. So in general, the unit of rate constant is equal to moles per liter per seconds. Now What is molecularity of a reaction? What is molecularity of a reaction? See, molecularity of a reaction is defined as how many number of molecules or atoms or ions which collide at a time. They collide simultaneously at one particular point of time, so that you will be bringing, they will be bringing about a product to me. This is called as molecularity of a reaction. So what is molecularity of a reaction defined as? It is defined as number of atoms or molecules or ions which collide simultaneously to give me the product. Say for example, in the reaction, there are two reactants which simultaneously collide to give me the product. So here the molecularity should be small a plus small b. Don't confuse your molecularity with the previous thing, that is, see children, almost your molecularity and the order are one and the same, but order is representing the exponents which are raised to the concentration terms. Okay, and what is molecularity? It is indicating the number of moles of concentration, number of moles which are indicating the concentration of reactant A and B. Okay, so it is nothing but small a and a small b. This is nothing but your molecularity of a reaction. See, if I am going to tell the molecularity of a reaction is 1, what does it indicate? It's a unimolecular reaction. If molecularity is 2, then it is called as bimolecular reaction. If molecularity is 3, it is trimolecular reaction. Say for example, ozone decomposes to give you oxygen and nitrogen. This is a unimolecular reaction. Hydrogen iodide decomposes to give you hydrogen and iodine. This is nothing but your bimolecular reaction. So it is nothing but number of molecules of a reactant which appear in the equation when the reaction is represented by a correct stoichiometric equation. When I am going to represent an equation in a correct stoichiometric order, in a correct stoichiometric sequence, how many number of molecules of reactants are present, or how many number of molecules of reactants are appearing in the reaction, that is also defined as molecularity of a reaction. Okay children, so till now we have seen what is chemical kinetics, what is nothing but the rate of a reaction, and we have seen what is rate constant, we saw what is order of reaction, in that we saw first order, second order, third order reaction. Then we saw what is molecularity of a reaction, what is unimolecular, bimolecular reactions we have seen. Okay children, thank you.